Hey everybody, it's 41. Welcome back to Mass Effect 2. The last time we recruited Tally for the second time in two games. And probably gonna go do a side mission this time since I still had to talk to the crew after the whole Haster mission.
Shepard?
Just checking in, making sure you're acclimatizing.
I was just sitting here thinking. The picture, I'm finally starting to get it. There's a tank imprint, the Battle at Canrum. A dead Turian, stripped. You don't see them out of their armor much. A Krogan boot on his head, and a claw hammer. It's under the brow plate, pulling it back, right? Eyes have gone black, and you see tension in the muscle. You can feel it ready to snap. I get it.
Canrum isn't ringing a bell.
Death of Shiagar, female warlord. Turians killed her, so they were hunted down and made examples. Even if they won the war, it was the last push before the rebellions ended.
Maybe I had to be there, but I don't get the joke.
There's no joke. It's just great. It's a Turian, and he's being torn apart for what they did. I felt nothing before, but now I get it. It was a good fight. The enemy was destroyed to punish them all and send a message. I get it. I hate Turians. Thought you'd be glad.
Wow. Breaking news. A Krogan hates a Turian.
I don't know if I'll be coming down here for these talks anymore.
Whatever. Don't have to be friends to fight good enemies. Just thought you'd like to know I'm finding reasons for my own battles.
That was disturbing. And yeah, that's primarily what talking to Grunt does. Also, because the FBA companies from way back when, we actually could talk to these guys, but I wanted to wait for Tally, because Tally does add a couple conversations. Nothing big, but
best, Commander. We just got those FBA couplings installed. Now we only have to calibrate every week instead of every day. We're thinking about celebrating our newfound free time with some Skillion 5 poker. Want to join us?
Come on, Kenneth. The Commander doesn't want to play cards with grease monkeys like us.
Actually, that sounds interesting.
You in, Tally?
Sure, that sounds fun.
Fantastic. I'll get the
cards. I wonder who's the ringer of the four of us. Maybe the one that's wearing a mask? Actually, you have to win because you're Commander Shepard. You have to be the god. You have to be great at everything. You're like, yeah. Yeah, doesn't make any sense at all. Commander Shepard, the whole world bends to him in Mass Effect. Yeah. It gets a little unnerving at times for me. It's like, come on. He's got to suck at something. Oh, wait, he does suck at something. He can't dance to save his life, but come on. That's like such a minute thing. Anyway, I need a renegade score.
You know, beating your superior officer...
Plus, it's kind of funny.
...would be a bad career move.
Yeah, okay. Nice playing, Commander.
Did Shepard's teasing throw off your game?
You mean that pulling rank shit wasn't serious? Oh man, I can't believe I fell for that. Beat me at my own game. You're all right, Shepard.
Yeah, Tally has a thing to say for every one of those, whether it's something like that or whether it's just like... Yeah, she even mentions a poker face at some point, if you pick one of the options. But yeah, that is that. So if there's nothing else to talk about, I'll meet you up at the thing and the galaxy map and start up something. Most galaxies at least have... Whoa, what the heck? What the heck? That cutscene's only supposed to play when you're... Oh, it was for nothing on top of it. That thing's only supposed to play when you're going into the mass relay, not, you know, going into another cluster in the same damn system. So, yeah, what the heck? And that one I am going to do. One thing I've noticed about these anomalies, they always seem to be on planets that look like, that sort of resemble Earth. It just seems to be some way, shape, or form. Oh yeah. And a lot of anomalies have element zero for some unusual reason.
Launching probe.
But anyway.
Protocol. Repeat. Unidentified.
Here is Aleem. It's a mercenary facility with Eclipse presence. Now is also the time where these Eclipse and all these merc missions come more available, and they actually have some sort of chain attached to them, which is kind of cool. And that's when you're going to be meeting Blue Suns, Eclipse, and Blood Pack a lot, because somehow you're going to get to do these things, whether you find them by accident out of order, or if you happen to find them in a certain order, you'll get an email on the next one. So anyway, for facing Eclipse, I'm going to want to bring someone that can warp. Miranda is the best for that. I want to show off Tally really bad, but I don't think this is the right time to show it, because Tally is not very good against Eclipse, in my opinion. Actually, I haven't shown off Kasumi in a while. Kasumi's not a bad option. Because if this mission is what I believe it is, then I'm going to have to be ready. Well, that makes a lot of sense. Oh, Shadow Strike now. Rapid Shadow Strike or Deadly? Well, if it reduces the cooldown by killing somebody with the power, then you better believe I would definitely think about this, because that means her cooldown would be 1.8 seconds, which is ridiculously awesome. So yeah, let's roll. I'll probably be facing, I'll face a few Eclipse on the way, but for the most part, it's a defend a station routine. Oh, and some bugs that aren't getting burned by flames like in the last part. Woohoo! Which means PETA will be off my case for another day. It's just a bunch of these cargo ship logs. They're nothing big. All they just show you is that the mercenaries are jerks. And, well, they are jerks. And jerks that must not be taken lightly. Which I am doing a very good job of taking lightly, because I just ran in like a kamikaze and killed two guys. Grabbing cover. And, of course, Eclipse are the ones that scream like little girls every time something bad happens to them. I kind of don't like facing them for that reason, because they scream. They squeal a lot. Which is great if you're trying to face somebody that you absolutely despise, but in this case, it just gets annoying. It's like that one case where you keep hearing somebody, and you're just like, shut up already, I'm sick of hearing you! Only the nightmare never stops, because you have to keep killing them off, and to keep killing them off, you have to hear the sounds. So you really can't win. So yep, they just raided a freighter, because that's what these mercs like doing. These are not nice mercs. These are evil mercs. And they must be treated accordingly. So let's see if Kasumi can kill this one off. Yep. So that means the cooldown should be very quick. Unless I didn't actually kill him off. Uh-oh, rockets. Well, if there's rockets involved, you know I'm bringing out the Mantis. Or I could just kill this guy off because he's being a jerk. Goodbye. Now we got that stupid rocket guy to worry about still. Hopefully this cloak will help. Oh shit! Yeah. Not a smart move. Being aggressive is okay, but not great. Blowing shit up is a good idea, though. Yeah, this is basically, you're just basically going to be in this part for the rest of the mission. Just doing what I'm doing. Because for the most part, all you're doing is just killing Eclipse, and then you have to defend something to kill mercs. To kill the mercs again, so you're constantly just standing here doing random shit. Negative contact. Cover. Come on, there's gotta be somebody you can kill, Kasumi. Kasumi died. And now I'm about to die very soon. Actually, wait a minute. No, I'm not.
We've been spotted.
I do sometimes forget about how just a first aid can help you in a tight situation. I'm not used to doing it, though. I've never actually done it before as much as I do now. Because back then, I only thought the Unity was good just when somebody died. But no, it actually has a use. I want to get these guys out of the way because I want to get that thing out of there. Now, if we go over here, we can extend this bridge. I would recommend not doing it because you extend the bridge, there's chances enemies can come here and come over here, go around, and flank you. The reason you want to do it is because there's 2,000 of a mineral there, but that's inconsequential to what I want to do. What we want to do is hack the machine. Very quickly hack the machine. We have a shipping log here, it shows blah blah blah, more resources and the like. But we have this encrypted data. We want to decrypt it. And naturally, because you can't decrypt stuff without something happening, you have to be under attack, which is swell. Very swell indeed. And of course, they have to bring out the big guns. No, not the Vanguard. The Vanguard's not the big gun, obviously. But there's gonna be named enemies and the like, you know. The fun guys. The fun crew that we know and love. Yes! I am gaining health right now, so shut up, help thingy. Oh great. They came from the other side. See, if you had the bridge there, you probably would have gotten cut off. Because, like I said, if they intermingle, it makes them a little tougher, in my opinion. That's why I definitely recommend not doing anything until... Oh, speaking of not doing anything. I want to make sure I get rid of these guys quick, because I think the worst guys do come from the other side, always. Otherwise, it's very random, I think, how they come out. But for the most part... Miranda, can you help me out here? Haha. Yeah, of course, Kasumi. I was only within 5 feet of the guy and decided to hit him with a headshot with an SMG. That kind of is easy to do. Alright, now here comes the big guys, I think. I'm 85% sure of this. And now I get to start headshotting things again. Oh, yep. If they're sending out those things. If they're sending out the combat drones, and you know the boss is around. Because only the boss is really ever capable of doing it. Yep. And we always want to get rid of the combat drone. Or we could let the combat drone go completely around. Because we're idiots. Alright, good. Captain Vorlian. And Eclipse Vanguard. Who don't figure to be part of the equation. Alright, let's go. Let's go, Captain. Don't care, I'm doing my part for the community. Let's go. And you can piss off. And now that they are completely destroyed, the decrypting conveniently becomes complete. And like I said, the bridge would lead you to the other side. So, kind of don't like that, especially if you get involved in one area. The real key is just stay composed and get rid of the waves as they come quickly and efficiently. And there you go. Decrypted data, and we're done with the mission. And we leveled up for it. Woo. So yeah. It's just a quick fill-up part, because... But... for the sake of completion, I chose to do it. So that pretty much will end this part. Unless there is something like a message that says you have another eclipse thing you can take care of right now, which is possible. I honestly don't remember how the sequences work. I always do them out of sequence, actually. The bullet pack one, for example, there's two missions, and I always do them out of order. Because one of them is one of my least favorite missions. Alright. It was an isolated incident. So, yeah, next time we will definitely be going to Ilium. So see you then. 40 Warriors signing off.